I wanted to say something else. Okay, thank you. God, you said, can we rock?
I will.
All right. Damn, I love him. I love him, dude. No, do what you gotta do.
No, it's just, we'll talk about it upstairs.
Okay. Now, number one, when you recognize when the Holy Spirit's dealing with you about a weakness in your flesh, you can call it a weakness in your flesh, I can call it a devil, but whatever, it's something that don't belong. Alright? Call it what you want. Whenever you're doing something that you know the Holy Spirit don't want you to do, and you can't stop doing it, then you got to, number one, you got to identify what it is. I don't know what it is. You got to know what it is. Identify it. Okay? After you identify it, that's number one. Then number two is you got to come out of agreement with it. You got to personally say, I come out of agreement with you, Angel. I don't want you no more. You see? Because that's aligning yourself up with the right light side. All right? So, in other words, you letting him know the jig is up, you know he's there, right, and you don't want nothing to do, and he about to get the boot. All right? But you got to give him the boot. He's been in your house for a long time.
Amen.
Whether he's in you, on you, or around you, he's got to come up, off, and away. So write that down. Because so many people worry about whether it's in you, whether it's around you. All I got to say is if it's a devil, he's got to come out, off, and away from you. Amen?
Amen?
So, okay, whether he's in, okay, let's see. What was the first part about?
Come out of agreement, number one.
Identify.
Okay, whether he's in you, on you, or around you. Is that what I said?
Yeah.
Okay, whether he's in you, whether he's on you, or whether he's around you. Thank you. Thank y'all. Everybody, thank you. All right. Whether he's in you, on you, or around you, he has to come out, off, and away. Whoever he is, and it's your job to do the homework because you are the control of this vessel. So your body's a temple of the Holy Spirit. You are to take charge of this vessel to make it holy because your body belongs to him. So he's giving us homework to do. Now, if he's in you or you around you, he's got to come out, off, and away, and he can no longer dwell in, around, or attach. He can no longer dwell in, around, or attach. Okay. Then the last part? Okay. He can no longer dwell in you. He can no longer dwell around you. And he can no longer attach himself to you. Come out in Jesus' name. You sleepy devil trying to distract this man from his purpose.
Jesus.
In Jesus' name. All right. He can no longer dwell in, around, or attach himself to me, right to me, myself, and I. And that's another story from another day. Maybe today, but that's all. I want to tell you about me, myself, and I. You are me, myself, and I. How do I know? Because you are a spirit, you have a soul, and you live in a body. Okay? You got the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, triune being. All right? So you could say me is your body, myself is your soul, and I is the spirit man. Okay, but anyway, so you get this quick little revelation. So yeah, when I pray, I say, you can no longer dwell in, around, attached to me, myself, and I, meaning my spirit, my soul, and my body, okay? No more, right, no more in this age, nor the age to come. You can no longer dwell in me, around me, or attach yourself to me, myself, and I in any way, shape, or form. I forgot. In any way, in any shape and in any form, way, shape, or form. You can no longer dwell in, around, or attach yourself to me, myself, and I in any way, shape, or form in this age, nor the age to come. Okay, so I mean, is this kind of getting you excited with a little revelation?
Amen.
Okay, so you are a triune being. Your soul is your mind, your will, and your emotions. How many of you know the mind is the battlefield? But you know why it's the battlefield? Because we don't personally take responsibility and bind our mind to the mind of Christ. He said, put on the mind of Christ. Do we put it on? We put on our helmet of salvation, but do we say, I bind my mind to the mind of Christ? So write that down. I bind my mind to the mind of Christ. Because you need to do this for yourself if you don't want these thoughts to be able to run rampantly. You're going to have thoughts that come, but as soon as you start casting them down and using your tools, then the devil says he's not omnipresent. He can't be everywhere at the same time. He comes, but when you use your tool, he says, man, I'll come back at an opportune time. When he ain't prayed up, when he ain't walking in love, when he ain't walking in the spirit, when he's not doing what he's supposed to do.
I bind my mind to the mind of Christ.
Because remember, we seated in heavenly places with him. This life we're living right now, we've been crucified with Christ. It's no longer Christ who lives, we who live, but Christ who lives in us. So if Christ lives in us, then we got to take his mind. We need the words of the Father. How can we have the words of the Father if we don't have the mind of Christ? All right? How are you going to have the heart of the Father if you don't protect your heart daily with the breastplate of righteousness and with the shield of faith to quench every fiery dart, flame, and arrow, and blazing missile of the enemy? And that, you got to have your armor in place. Prayer brings inner strength to God's warriors, sending them forth to a spiritual battle with their muscles firm and with their armor in place. That's what prayer does. Y'all want to like that? Y'all want to write that down? Prayer brings inner strength to God's warriors. All right, if you're all right, you won't get sleepy and you won't get prayer time.
Amen.
All right, prayer brings inner strength to God's warriors, sending them forth into a spiritual battle with their muscles firm and their armor in place. That's what prayer does. You know what prayer is? With their muscles firm and their armor in place. Prayer brings inner strength to God's warriors, sending them forth into a spiritual battle. With their muscles firm and their armor in place. Right under that, I want you to write pray, put a hyphen, and then ER.
Okay.
Well, write what you can. I'm going to say it one more time. Stand up and stretch and touch your toes. Stand up and stretch. Everybody stand up and stretch right now. All right? Now, I want everybody to scream. We need a breakthrough.
Yeah.
Jesus!
You are the Lord of the breakthrough.
And if you got to run forget yourself, right?
Amen.
And then let's get back.
All right.